Hi everyone and welcome to Newsclick. I'm Apoorva and here we give you the glimpse of some of the most important stories that made headlines today. Our first news is from Kashmir, where a three-day-long encounter ended in Handwara in North Kashmir. In the 60-hour-long gunfight, 8 persons, including 2 militants and 4 government force personnel, were killed and 11 others were injured. On Saturday morning, elite paracommandos from 3rd and 9th Battalion joined the already strengthened posse of government forces. The encounter broke out during the night between February 28th and March 1st, after the joint team launched a cordon and search operation. A civilian was also allegedly killed by the action of the government forces amid clashes near the gunfight site on Friday. On the other hand, despite the heavy rain, thousands of people attended the funeral prayers of slain Lashkar-e-Taiba militant who was killed in this gunfight in his native village Brath. In a media address today, Air Chief Marshal B.S. Dhanoa said that the Indian Air Force doesn't count how many people died. He was responding to the question on the number of terrorists killed in the February 26th airstrike targeting a terror training camp in Pakistan's Balakot, which has created a political row. He further explained, and I quote, "Air Force is not in a position to clarify how many people were inside. We don't count human casualties. We count what targets and we have hit or not hit." However, in his speeches, BJP President Amit Shah has claimed that 250 terrorists have been killed. On the day of the strikes, a figure of 300 did the rounds, but no one gave it on record. The Air Chief said it was for the government to say how many were hit. In our international segment, we are talking about Sudan, where President Omar al-Bashir's desperate attempts to stay in power by imposing emergency in Sudan has backfired, as protests against him intensified. Bashir declared emergency on February 22nd, dissolving his cabinet and local governments for at least 1 year. He also provided the security forces a greater authority and impunity while cracking down on protesters. On February 28th, a day after the emergency courts were established, many thousands yet again took to streets across the country, continuing to press their demands that Bashir be removed from the presidency, which he had occupied through a coup 30 years ago. For over 2 months now, the Sudanese people, undaunted by the repressive measures which have cost many lives, have been fighting to oust the regime and replace it with a transitional government. So that's all we have for you today in our Daily Roundup segment. To see detailed reports on these stories, please log on to our website www.newsclick.in and follow us on Facebook. Thank you.